welcome to episode 5 of Bass in Session. We've been on hiatus for a few months, so I decided to reward everyone, or penalize, however you look at it, with a special 1-hour episode of Bass in Session. Today's episode features me and Chicky on the Delaware River fishing for smallmouths. We decided to do a little different technique with the camera today, and that is that we didn't turn off the camera at all like we normally do and turn it back on. We just let it roll, so this is more of a freestyle episode, if you will. I hope you enjoy it. Thanks for your patience. And let's go catch some smallmouths on the Delaware River. I've heard a few complaints that my previous Bass Holes commercial was a little corny. So instead of listening to me, why don't you listen to my good friend Lou? He'll tell you all about the Bass Holes.
Hi, I'm Lou, retired PSG. I'm a member of the Bass Holes, greatest fishing club you ever want to find. Y'all need to look it up on the internet and get in on it with the rest of us poor addicted bass fishermen. Take care, and if you get there, say hi to Jared for me.
Well, it all got started with a lonely fishing rig. My trusty rod, along with my rainbow jiggling jigs. Got plenty of spirit, this day would be my day. No time to say so long, won't be that far away. I get this urgency, weighs heavy on my mind. Now don't you worry, wouldn't throw you no line. Love's a lot like fishing, sometimes it hits real quick. Other times you're better off just hanging up in the sticks. Bass holes forever, it's plain to see. Ain't nothing wrong being wet, wild and free.
Hello, ladies. Big Val Bosky here. Val Venus, and you're watching Bass in Session with Steve the Teacher.
Well, folks, you're witnessing what I consider to be the toughest part of the whole fishing ordeal. It is 4:20 in the morning. I am driving up Route 130 to pick up Chicky. I'm going to be picking him up, and then we're going to be heading up another hour or so, go up the Delaware River for some small water fishing. I'm exhausted. This is my only chance to sleep all week long. 3 jobs now, plus all my fishing endeavors. The worms and the sponsorships and the TV show. And when I should be sleeping, here I am on my way up to the Delaware River. Well, hopefully it all pays off. Hopefully we'll have an interesting episode today.
From episode 1, when we were on Lake Amistad in Texas. Whee! Not the same thing, huh?
Tom, you were here when we had that tournament, right?
Yes, Mr. Co-host. So what's the difference between 225 horsepower and 9.9 horsepower?
About 60 miles per hour.
Seems to be. We're doing this without a seatbelt. There, you can see the sun trying to come up. The beautiful New Jersey air. That was supposed to be sarcastic. And I believe we are in the antique capital of New Jersey, from what I hear. We have New Hope, Pennsylvania, right over here. It's supposed to be an artsy, craftsy kind of place. And we have New Jersey over here. It's supposed to be New Jersey. Which exit? Ha 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 ha! There's my seat where my butt goes. Enjoy that.
And we're on the non-tidal part of the Delaware River.
Man, I wish I videotaped my backing of the trailer. It was classic. One swift motion. Last year, it took me about 25 minutes. Unfortunately, I didn't know there was that big pothole there, but now I know. That's not what we're going for today, though, is it?
No.
No.
Oh, man.
Hi, this is Steve the Teacher, host of Bass in Session. We are proudly sponsored by Hog Thrasher Jigs. Let's take a look at the fine products made by Hog Thrasher Jigs. Dirty Water Special on a giant football head. How about bubblegum? Midnight Red. Here's the Threadfin Shad. Watermelon Red. My personal favorite, Bluegill. Okeechobee Blue with Rattle. Dirty Water Special on a giant football head. Peanut butter and jelly.
Hog Thrasher Jigs. Tight lines to all, and to all a good fight.
If you think Hog Thrasher is just jigs, well, let me tell you, you got another thing coming. Check this out. It's my Hog Thrasher Swimmer. Look at that peacock color. Beautiful. I love it. One second. Say Hog Thrasher Shaky Head. And the balls come in all different colors. Are you ready for this? The Hog Thrasher Spinnerbait comes in the same colors that all the jigs come in. Check this out. Hog Thrasher, he's more than just jigs. Hog Thrasher Jigs. Quality jigs at a great price. And colors you couldn't even imagine. 28 colors in all. Go to hogthrasher.com to order your product now. Hog Thrasher Jigs. Tight lines to all, and to all a good fight.
Watermelon Candy, Kamikaze, Senko type worm on. I do not yet own a 4-inch mold, which will be remedied this afternoon. I'm going to try a different technique of the hat cam today, since we're expecting so many bites today, which is just leaving it on and turning it off every now and then, resetting and deleting. The beauty of a hat cam, I can let this run an hour, decide that I don't want to keep the footage, delete it, and start all over again. Chicky's throwing his precious inline spinner. He is the master of the MEPS, I call him. Actually, I just made that up. Alright, even though I'm leaving the camera running, folks, don't feel like it's my job to entertain you the entire time. I'm here to fish. I'm thinking, well, it's still dark-ish. It's early yet. Let's break out. The spinnerbait for now and save the plastic until it warms up just a touch. I have a quarter ounce Booyah on here. In chartreuse, obviously, with a willow blade on the bottom and a small Colorado on top. Where's that cha-ching booyah? I can definitely see it there, so I guess the water's clearer than I thought. This might have to switch colors up a little bit later. Maybe sooner than later. Switch this to a white, perhaps. Yeah, I can see it 25 feet away. I hope you guys can see the spinning of the blades there underwater. By the way, we're looking at the Pennsylvania side of the Delaware River. In case you're curious. I think that person has some money. Chicky is doing a masterful job at the trolling motor. As he once told me, it is an extension of his foot. Sounds a little pompous at the time, but that's proven true. Glad I got that off my chest. The only thing with this smaller spinnerbait is I'm not getting quite the distance on the cast I want. But it sure looks pretty. Some wood coming up. This might be a good time to switch up to plastic, perhaps. I think I shall. Beautiful cast. Chicky just hooked me. Right. He just caught a 240-pound flounder. Unfortunately, because of this current, we are going by this wood probably faster than we would like, but we got 6 hours, so we can always pass it again. my worm has come dislodged from the hook, so I am going to embed it further. And I can tell you for a fact that won't happen with a teacher worm. Yeah, I'm a whore chick. Yes. Oh, I get the Steve Martin reference now. I thought you were talking about the comedian. But you're doing a play on the Roland Martin.
Yeah.
Got it. Took me a while. Four concussions can do that to a person. Look at it, it's already out of the worm already. One cast. This is gonna be a long day if I have to keep doing this. You hear that, kamikaze worm people? Whoever you are. Okay, it is now skinned in nicely. Oh, look at this brush pile here. And a horrible cast right into a tree, folks. So much for that worm. Okay. Well, this would be a good place to turn off the camera while I tie the hook back on.
Teaching you how to lure, first thing you have to make sure that you have all the equipments. First you get a boat, you'll probably need a safe coat. You'll sometimes use your rod. When you get the worms, don't worry about the germs. You can't just use a net, you won't even break a sweat. Fishing is like a passion. No, we don't need compassion. We fish by the lake, some things is fake. We take it easy and relax, we watch each other's backs. You enjoy the thrill, it almost seems unreal. They put up a good fight, make sure they don't bite. We handle them with care, you might get a little scared. You have to learn techniques, this probably takes weeks. You'll learn it all here, we'll wait for you and cheer. The more people you meet, the more you can compete. I'll have it all here, make it all appear. You'll always have fun until the show is done.
You see, I'm throwing a rather small lipless crankbait, a Cordell spot, silver body, blue back. Not used to throwing them this small, but you must adjust. I don't know if you could see it. I certainly can. The water is extremely clear and pretty shallow right about here. I don't like the casting of something this light. Got a little backlash there. Let me fix it on this cast. strange when the water's this clear, because I don't see nothing. But they're here. I guess that's what's called a natural eddy right over there. You see the water picking up speed as it's being redirected off those branches. I don't like the feel of this at all, folks, so I'm switching. It just ain't cutting the mustard, folks. Man, the current doesn't look this fast, but when you're in the boat, it is. I got snagged on that log there. I thought I had something for a minute. I'm sure my worm will look worse for wear. Not bad. Thought I had something. But that's okay. Oh, look at this. The stairs to nowhere. Walk to the water. By the way, folks, while the camera was off, Chickie and I both got about 15 smallmouth, which we proceeded to release very quickly. So, unfortunately, we were not able to catch it. But those are all the rules and regulations of this time of year in this part of the country. My fish were bigger. Here, smallie, 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 smallie. You know, folks, my only, I don't want to say a problem, because it's not a problem, but my only wish with this hat cam is that you can experience all five senses, because I'm rather gassy today, and you're really missing out on some good stuff here. Just thought I'd share that with you. If I remember later, I got a new shipment of El Grande lures in. I'll show them to you. I brought some with me. Some tequila-scented tubes. Might just work today, actually. Smallies like tubes, right? Very first bass I ever caught was on a tube. Didn't even know what I was doing. Cooper River. Had my daughter with me and brought in that bass on that tube, and she looked at me and said, "Daddy, I'm impressed." And that may have been the last bass I caught for quite some time after that. More stairs leading to the water. Goodbye, Mr. Canadian Goose. I keep reading about these 50 to 100 bass days that so many people have, and I've yet to experience anything even remotely like that in my bass fishing lifetime. This river. Just up further in Poconos area, right? I think the best I've really had, now that I think about it, is all those trout over at Merrill Creek that time when we hit that hot spot. Probably 25 between us in 10 minutes. And then 8 hours of nothing. Until, yeah. Yeah, that was it. Well, this worm is holding up better, so I guess I can't really blame Mr. Kamikaze, if there is such a person. Must have been my rigging, because now it's fine. Last time we were here, we had a little pool going between five boats, I think it was, or four boats, whatever it was. We came in second. Cha-ching! I think that was the first time I took money home. No, that's not true. There's a duck right there at his house. Duck must have a good job to have a house like that. Don't you, Mr. Ducky? In case you can't see him, I'm gonna try and cast right at him. There, that was pretty good.
I'm a sock having a house here, because when the river floods, it's gotta come up to at least them first windows.
I wonder if that, you see how the color changes on the wood there?
Yeah.
I wonder if that's water.
Sometimes River Road even floods. Look how high that is.
thought I had a nibble there. Thought I had a nibble. Somebody's doing some sawing. At 7 a.m. on a Sunday morning, that's a considerate neighbor for you folks. How'd you like to live next to that?
I can't say nothing because I do it.
I was going to say, that might be you. I was going to say that.
Well, I live in Philly. There is no time limit. You can saw 2 o'clock in the morning if you want.
Oh, no, I understand that there's no limit, but... The guy who used to own the house before me was noted for mowing his lawn at 2 and 3 in the morning, and the neighbors didn't take too kindly to that. So I was kind of a welcome addition to the neighborhood. I personally don't see how you mow the lawn in the pitch black, but maybe you had one of those miner caps on or something, I don't know. Yeah, I know it's only a straight line, but I still wouldn't be able to do it. I could barely go in a straight line when I'm driving. Always drink responsibly, folks. And for our fans watching down in the south, hold the beer can between your legs when you're driving your pickup truck. How's that for alienating half the audience? You don't like it? Fuck yeah. Here, Smalley, 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 Smalley. Not sure if I've stated this on camera yet, but it's funny to watch the phases that I appear to go through. When I first started fishing, all I used was plastics. The following summer, it was almost entirely crankbaits. Now here I am back to plastics again, partly based on watching this guy fish all last summer and killing me with his constant use of plastics. I guess that's part of it.
Last year you basically fished everything that the fish weren't biting.
Pretty much, yes. In fact, I think it said that on the envelope, or the package rather. I ruined that joke. These guys are making some kind of retaining wall slash deck here.
How you doing?
Looking good. What are those, like 6x6s? They ain't 4x4s. Let's aim for that boat. I think we caught some here last year. Aha. That boat gets no props. Ha ha ha. You gotta put rocket fuel in there or what?
What? Slower.
Really?
Yeah, I think they get less horsepower. They're good for here though, all rocks.
More expensive?
I'm not sure. I imagine it's probably good.
I wonder if Jürgen could fix jet motors. Binga, 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 Jürgen. What do we got there? A floating chair? Man-made cover. I gotta say, throughout this trip, I'm not really pleased with how this area smells. We've had skunk already, there's something else going on. If anyone's gonna stink up this place, it's gonna be me. I guess a lot of people had boats here or had them at one time, with all these steps into the water. If I could walk on water. Na 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 na. All right, now that we got the net on, the net is now accessible. I'm sure that was the kiss of death. Smoke. Smoke. That was my subliminal messages, a la Family Guy. Are you smoking yet? Family Guy is property of Fox Television. I've got two rods with broken eyes there. That's not something you fix, huh?
Huh?
Is that something you've ever fixed?
No, I've never tried that.
Make any jigs lately?
I haven't made any in a while. Since I've been back to work. Well, if you want it, I just got some more lead. I'm gonna order a couple more molds. I got a shitload made.
Pontoon boat. When I went to Oklahoma, I was forced to bass fish out of a boat like that, having never driven any kind of boat before. It was interesting, to say the least. That's not true. I did have my John boat at that point. I take it back. But quite a switch there. First time ever driving an outboard, for sure. Well, the schneid is over. Just when he was saying we should pull off the bank and hit deeper water. Got it.
Oh, and these river smallies are the best. This little tiny thing fought like a 10-pounder.
No, 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 no.
Now
you know
I gotta get my camera out.
Look at the baby ducks! Look at the baby ducks! I'm gonna try and zoom in here if I can. Yeah, you probably can't see them at all. Yeah. Oh well, worth a shot.
That's something I would not have as part of
a duck? Or a duck. Especially with assholes like us casting right at it. Ba-dink! Ba-dink! Well, looking at the house though, I think you can afford to fix it. I could pitch right into that boat. That would be pretty funny. Woo! We are filming that. Good. Okay. I thought Chickie was going to reel in a mama duck. The beauty of HatCam. Leave the HatCam running. You never know what you're going to get. And if you don't want it, you can delete it. You still have the footage. Hey, snails, my dinghy's bigger than your whole boat. That's a quote from Caddyshack, in case you didn't catch it. So, let's dance. Well, folks, I went against what I said I was going to do, which was leave the camera running. And guess what happened? Chicky caught a fish. You did see that little, depending on my editing, of course. You will see it, if you haven't already seen it. But now I have to do what I said. And not what I did. We got a big tree underneath us here. We got a waterfall here. And now we got a worm stuck in the rocks, probably. Oh, I was able to finesse him out of there. Another few more minutes of this and I will be wacky rigging this thing.
Just opened the pack of cigarettes, didn't
I? You sure did. I'm sure you do.
When my fucking season's been going, I planned for it.
Oh.
The day I brought 2 packs because I'll smoke 2 packs if I ain't catching them.
I think I had a little tap there. Did not commit. That's a shame. That is a shame, 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 shame. Come on, watermelon candy. If this were a teacher worm, I would have had 10 by now. Prove me wrong. Well, this is the first day I remembered to bring the suntan lotion, the sunblock. And so far, it doesn't look like I'll be needing it, which is okay. In fact, it's better. Fish-wise, right? Looks like Chicky's calling it a day. We're getting right near the launch already. He caught his one. He doesn't care about me. Man, one chop of an axe and that boat could be yours. It's secured by a rope. If the camera suddenly goes off, folks, we are stealing that boat. You know what I like about best about this river is you can't get lost. Can we go on a boat, right, Chicky? Can we go on a boat? Can we take it on a boat? Please, 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 please. Yes, ladies and gentlemen, is the president of the Steve the Teacher fan club watching us? I don't know if you can see that sign, but it says they sell erotic ice cream. I'll take a chocolate vagina, please. No strawberry sauce, please. Oh, it says exotic, not erotic. I'm sorry. I'm not an English teacher on the weekends. About our third dockside restaurant. With the Landshark beer umbrellas. Umbrellas. Can you tell I'm from New York? Umbrellas. Every now and then I slip back into that. Obviously, the ducks have been doing some spawning lately. How about the smallmouth, though? Boink! Catch that duck. Here's a dreaded phenomena in New Jersey, which hopefully you don't have to deal with in your part of the country, but
yeah, these assholes are all over.
Yeah. Rowers truly believe that they own the water, it belongs to them. I have never seen that many people on a... I don't think that's legal. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 20 rowers
would enjoy watching it.
Twenty rowers, a coach, and a coxswain. And that's as dreaded as zebra mussels or cormorants or any other bass fishing epidemics that you can encounter.
They're like equivalent to the fucking snakehead. That was a different kind of boat though. That ain't like the ones they usually have.
No.
Today's free tip. When injecting hot plastics using an aluminum injector, make sure that after you feel the initial resistance from the injector, don't push it with all your might, or this could happen. By the way, how do you like my boxers? Here's the newest addition to the Steve the Teacher family. His name is Chicklet, named after Chicky, who was the one who actually caught him. He's in a 55-gallon tank. He's got a 70-gallon filter. He was fed earlier today. You do see some goldfish, some rosy minnows. Down here is a crayfish, which so far they have some kind of agreement between Chicklet and the crayfish. He seems to be doing very well. He seems to be happy. Oh, maybe he'll eat one right now. Nope. I'll run the camera the next time. I promise. Here he goes again. Nope. Here it is, folks. The video you all wanted to see. My Chicklet about to feed. I have some help from my beautiful assistant. You may fire when ready, Grizzly. Here they come. Boom. 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 Oh, I think he's camera shy. Zoom in.
Oh.
Is that a goldfish?
Mm-hmm.
Woo!
He keeps his eye on the target.
Yeah. I have to zoom out, he's moving so fast. Oh. Yep, now he's smiling for the camera. Okay, he's chewing a little bit. Oh, oh, he just got that goldfish real fast.
Oh my god.
Okay, well, you get the idea, right?
Oh, man.
Yo, that's your show. Good night.
I got five in the live, and they all nice size. I got five in the live, and it's about that way in time. I got five in the live, and they all nice size. I got five and alive, and it's about that way in time. Writing again with my residents in pen, explaining the way they break away from too much tension. That's a good looking spot over by those rocks. Underneath those willow trees or over by the docks. I need to cover plenty of water and be sure to go slow. Got no work tomorrow, kiss my daughter, grab my poles. Tell my wife no need to worry, cause you know where I be. Catching mean show bass on the old Mogi. Fishing fathers come and holler by three. What's up? It's a nice day. Have you had any luck? I make a cast or two and say I got a bass or two. But it's five and alive, and they all nice size. I got five and alive, and they all nice size. I got five and alive, and it's about that way in time. I got five and alive, and they all nice size. I got five and alive, and it's about that way in time. I just hate it when it's cold, hunting's good but fishing slow. What's the pattern? Oh no, fish a creek bed or a show. I might take it to a cold, fish your feet like a pro. Texas rig or big and jig suspending crank, y'all know. Crank it, stop, jerk and let it drop. You should feel some pressure in between before it bottoms out. Set the hook, bow it up. This bad man, my jammer here, show is tough. Put your tip down, it's coming up. If he get a good jump, I might look. I don't know who the word he thought I was. You see 5-3, don't play that, bro. It's about my time to turn it up. Pull back, I see he's coming up. One more good pull, he's had enough. I thought that.